Hey all, and welcome to another video. So today we've got something a little bit the same, a little bit different, and we are be looking at Hikvision Intercom again. And yeah, it's just the basic setup we're going to do, just a door station and a screen. But the difference is today we are going to be configuring this offsite. Okay, so imagine you have a job with a customer and you don't want to spend, you don't have long there, you don't want to spend ages sitting on your laptop configuring away. All you want to do is take the system with you, mount it, plug it in, and you're ready to go. Okay, so this is what we're going to show you how to do today, is basically pre-configure your Hikvision Intercom at home, ready to take with you on site. Okay guys, so hopefully this could save some of you guys hours of videos and just sitting there. You know, sometimes things don't work properly, sometimes you're at the site and it's not a very good location, or you have to do it outside, it's raining, who knows guys. I'm telling you, sit at home, relax, make a nice cup of tea, set configure your intercom in the nice office environment, and then you're ready to go on site. Okay guys, it's a no-brainer to me. This is how I will do it every time. So how do we do it? Yeah, that's what's coming up in the video. So I've broken it down into three parts. First of all, you need to find out your IP range of the site you're gonna be going to. Okay, it's really easy to find, and you need a few IP addresses to write down and then save them. And then we're going to do a basic intercom setup, okay? So it'll be slightly different, just IP wise, and you'll see that in the setup. And then right at the end, we're going to quickly fix the IP and give it a test, okay? So hopefully you guys, yeah, some of you guys are going to absolutely love this video, save you a lot of time and headache on site. So yeah, I really hope this guy, this helps you out. And if it does, please guys, don't forget to like, subscribe, and please leave a comment if you have any comments. It really does help with the YouTube algorithms. All right, so let's go ahead now and try and find your IP range. All right, thanks, bye bye. All right guys, so on our PC now, and we're going to assume that this is your customer's PC on the location where you're going to install your intercom, okay? So what we're going to do is find out the IP range, and then I'm going to change the router over, and we're going to set it up on a different router and then test it out on this IP range, okay? So to find out the IP range, we go to type in CMD, all right? Now in the command prompt, we type in IP config. Okay, then /all. Now this brings up all our IP information that we're going to need. Okay, so I'll just get this command and I'll paste it here. Okay, so you guys can see it. All right, so we've got the information here, like our IP address of our PC is 10.4.4.7.1. Okay, so our subnet mask is this. So we're going to need this information for later. So we'll write that down now. All subnet masks are generally the same. So okay, and then our default gateway. Okay, so our default gateway is basically our IP range. Okay, so this is our range. It's 10.4.4.1 to 10.4.4.254. okay guys, so we have to find a few IP addresses that we can use in this range, and we're gonna allocate those to the intercom. Okay, so now we have to find a free one. Okay, so first of all, before I find a free one, I'm going to find one that's taken already. I'll go 10.4.4.14. okay, I know this is our DVR we have at work. Okay, so we get a reply back from this IP address. It's here, that means it's taken. It's saying, look, we're here, what do you want? Okay, so we don't want to use that IP address. Okay, we're going to get a conflict and it's not good. So let's try a higher number. Okay, so high numbers generally safe. So go 10.4.4. Let's try 150. Okay. All right, unreachable. That means it can't find anything with this IP address. Okay, so this is perfect. So this will be our main IP address we're going to use for the main door station. So I go door station IP. And then we're going to go main screen. IP. And now let's try 10.4.151. Oh, maybe because I didn't do ping. Okay, ping 151. Oh, there we go. So it's pinging. Unreachable. Okay then, so we can use this for our main IP address. For our main screen, it's going to be 151. Okay, so depending on how many intercom devices you have and screens, you can just keep going down the list and keep assigning IPs to your units. Okay, and I'll do the same with IP cameras as well, and just so they're all on a nice little range which you can allocate and look after. Okay guys, so now I'm going to go flip over to IVMS and we're going to do the rest of the setup there. Catch you in a sec. All right guys, before we go over to IVMS 4200, I'm going to quickly show you our little setup we have here. Okay, so here's our door station and screen, just plugged into our little PoE switch, and we have one cable here going to our router. Okay, so this is a different router than we just used on the little IP video, and this is not even connected to the internet, this one. Okay, so this is going to be used just for setting up. Okay, but you can use any router really, it doesn't matter. And we have then our red cable connected to our PC. Okay, so this is literally like kind of like a local area kind of network we set up here. Let's quickly test the doorbell.
Calling failed.
Yeah, it's not going to work. But now I'm going to show you guys how to get it to work. All right, see you in a sec. All right then guys, so back on over to the PC. I'm going to do the setup on IVMS, but quickly show you now the new router range. Okay, so if you guys are interested in that. As you see now, we have an IP address of 192, okay, so 168.1.103, okay, so we've changed that. We've added the serial numbers to our little list, so it's handy to have your list ready to make a setup really nice and easy. Okay, now on IVMS, as you see here, we've got our online devices, we have our door station inactive, our camera, oh, this is our camera at the bottom inactive, and we have our smart switch, okay, so we don't need to do anything on the smart switch. Let's just activate our devices and add them to the main part here. Okay, so you can activate, put in your password. Like usual guys, I would recommend just one password for everything, but it's up to you how you do it. Okay, so device active. Now we're going to enable DHCP. So we are going to use just the local new range, the 192 range. Okay. All right, so now we'll refresh. And now you see we've got a brand new IP address here, okay, 104. So let's go ahead and add this device to our main panel. Okay, so add main door station. We go add. Okay, online, it's found it. Okay, and we do exactly the same thing to our screen. Okay, so we go activate, same password. Okay. Okay, just come up with an error. My IVMS, I don't know, it's a bit slow, but it works. Okay, so now we've activated it. Let's go ahead and enable DHCP. Okay. Okay, that's done. We're going to refresh. Now we go ahead and add our screen. Okay. So we go internal screen. Right. Go add. Now both of our devices here online. Okay, so first of all, we click on our main door station and we're going to add the screen to our main door station. All right guys, so I go device management and we're going to go add. So we're going to add internal station. All right, the password we just entered, same password again. All right, the serial number of the screen. Okay, so we got our serial number here. Okay, IP address. Okay, so we're going to put in this IP address, okay, the one we're going to designate for our customer. Okay, use all this information we took earlier. Default gateway and floor number 1 and 1. Okay, because it's a simple setup we're going to be doing. Go okay. So as you see here on the left, it's going to say offline, but it will say offline. Okay, there's nothing you could do about that for now. All right, now we go to our screen. Click on our screen. something going on with the screen here. Okay, some reason it's because I used the screen before, it's been a bit funny about the IP address. So let me just delete the screen. Let's enable DHCP again. Okay, let's go ahead and add it again. Oh, hopefully now, guys, okay, now we can back on, okay? Because we're using the screen 100 times, I don't know, it gets confused or something, but... All right, so we go to network, and then we go group network settings, and now here we have our main door station IP, okay? This is not what we want here. Our main door station IP is designated to be this one. So copy and paste that into here, put in the password, and click on save. All right, make sure it says saved at the bottom here as well. Okay, so now our screen should be linked to our main door station. And when you go to the door station and log onto it, usually, guys, it will say here online, but it's not gonna say online because the IP address is different from the one we've given it, okay? So I'm going to flip over now to the live view and show you it doesn't work. Then I'm going to show you the solution, what to do, and do the final test. All right, catch you there. All right, so let's check
calling
it.
Failed.
Okay, calling failed. Okay, it's going to fail because even though we set the IP address as correct, the actual IP address on the station and in the internal screen are wrong. So let's go now and fix that. All right, and then it should work. Right, so now our last step, and now what we're going to do is we're going to change the IP address of our main units right at the bottom here, okay? So we've got our door station here, so we're going to edit network parameters, okay? So we're not going to have DHCP enabled, no. We're going to use this IP address here, we're going to give it this one, we're going to give it the gateway, and we're going to put in the password. Okay. So now we've got our 1044150 password, okay? We'll do the same on our screen, edit the parameters, take it from here, okay? For some reason the screen has been funny today, guys, sorry about this. Okay, so now we've got our two IP addresses. Now what I'm gonna do is, that is the setup done, guys. So what I'm gonna do is show you how it works, do a quick test, and then that pretty much wraps up the video. So thanks for watching. Now you can do pre-configuration at home, save you hours on site, and don't forget to like and subscribe the video, guys, if you found it interesting. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you another one. Cheers, bye. All right, guys, so let's do the final test now. All we have to do is ring the bell. There we go, it's ringing. All right, guys, so now we could do configurations at home. Thanks for watching, and see you later. Bye-bye.